please.
Okay, thank you. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Department of English, this is Manur Khadu, welcoming you to the fourth session of the remote lecture series Confab 2021. Today, we are very happy to have in our list Dr. Sarkar, Associate Professor, Department of English, Rishi Chandra College, Naihati. Dr. Shubh Sarkar has been teaching as an Assistant Teaching English as an Associate Professor at Rishi Chandra College for the last 22 years in EG courses and 12 years in PG courses. He has done his doctoral research on European experience on post-1960 American time. He has received the Theatre Research Grant Award in 1997 from the American Studies Research Center, Hyderabad, and has completed a UGC MRP, Impact of European Drama on Indian Theatre. He has published many articles on literature, drama, poetry, fiction, performance and ecology. His areas of interest include European drama, Indian drama, British romantic literature, modern poetry, women's writings, Dalit studies, literature from the margins of class, caste and gender, performance theory, Marxist literary criticism, and experimental drama and theatre. Now, today he is going to talk about some Beckett's book. Without further ado, let me request our honorable speaker, Dr. Shubh Sarkar, to address us. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Professor Manu Khadu, for this. And I do thank Dr. Manu Thank you. experiences of fascism in Europe, the experiences of World War II, the advent of nuclear weapons, and the communication and distribution of intellects. Naturally, the resulting metaphysical preoccupation is less surprising in France, a country where philosophy has long been considered an important part of society. Than it would have been in England or America. The new metaphysics is reflected in diverse forms. However, a more lasting impression on the mind of the Europeans who were greatly involved with the war and had eventually lost a sense of certitude and to regard this wasteland of communism as a comment on the First World War. Then it is this day, waiting for Godot, was composing and should be regarded as a more convincing form of the Second World War. In 1961, an artist published a book called The Theatre of Acts. This book, the book included Samuel Beckett, Harold Wilton, Hans Krogh, Arthur Adamoff, Fernando Mirabal, and it was all three. Arnold book The Absurd includes Beckett among the major absurd experiments. The term absurd, according to Jane Watson, implied atheism, the absence of value, moral category, insufficiency of reason, and the need to create own standards. If priority to existence of essence and created for it, for the word, French institutions like Camus popularized the term in literature because of for Camus the sense of estrangement between man and the world, in spite of their coexistence, makes the human condition absurd. Absurd frees man from all feeling of responsibility. Absurd annihilates the future and leaves only the sensation of the world. By focusing on the myth of Sisyphus, who is forever condemned to the role dropped up on the theory, Camus brings out the lucidity and tension of living the world and springs from history. For Sartre, absurdity is based on, quote Sartre, being eternally entangled with existence. Hannah Arden, in the same French institution, has stated that for Camus, man is essentially a stranger because the world in general and man as man are not people. And we are together. The theme of waiting for Godot. It of course uses this. So in waiting for Godot, I think that is called a waiting. Two chapters come, read it, and pass through the intercepting space twice. Intercepting space is of course a partition, axiomatic point, where the vertical and the horizontal axis. And then we have two boys coming on the stage telling the fans that perhaps Godot will come tomorrow. All the adult characters and here pulling up. Presented as individual things, which obviously does not belong to the world. And Camus, here also defined that man does not exist simply as a man, among men. In the way animals exist among animals, or the trees, among trees, all of which exist and exist, so to speak, the ruler. For both of these, an urgency and a restlessness in Kali, and a desperation in this struggle. Yet, probably they are left alone on the spectre of whiskers. They intervene them for a while, before the one who comes does not be substantial to them. This is this urgency and restlessness that we find in Vladimir and the desperation in the struggle to meet Godot while they are left alone. With all their expectations, with all the monotony of waiting and institution revolt, they try to reason out wear these costumes. They make themselves meaningless. Because they are endowed with the gift of wisdom. Everything appear, to be given to them. Fulfilling the purpose of this wedding for an unknown person in an undefined space.
No solution. I'm going to do it.
moral, religious, political, and social structures that human beings have created. What is that? Evolution themselves have all collapsed. Answer equals orthodoxy. Monotony, savagery, absurdity, repetitive human action, failure of. Even the failure of human relationship can be regarded as an example of the theater of absence. It dramatizes the inner landscape of a human being, split into the material and the spiritual half. When God is coming as that spiritual half, then, of course, Vladimir represents the spiritual part of that man. It can be even interpreted as a psychological drama. In which fantasy mingles with fact to reveal the dark processes of the human mind. The play is also a dance of death, although this is in a classical manner, enacted on a modern post-war wasteland. The plot is, as I said earlier, is almost cyclical, yet also non-chronological, and is ordered from action. The plot is, of course, very typical. There is no or executable stream of consciousness, past, present, and the future are all intermingled. And the practical nature of time, almost 2 to 3 hours, space-time, becomes a metaphor of interacting both ends. Of course, they downs by the non-arrival of Godot. The life of failure and being chose. The savage ritual of endless waiting is presented against the backdrop of a decadent, materialistic, degenerated, and of course morally bankrupt society. It presents a distinction, stark picture of the world. Game of revelry, on play, on verbal games, it is very interesting games, moving through different theatrical devices that are used in theater, comedia, staccato, monologues, crossbow. But we feel the real and absent, a kind of horrific world, which is technological and full of animals and bizarre happiness. In 1962, Edward R. Bee, an article, "This theater is the absurd one," pointed out that the theater of the absurd is an absorption in art of certain existentialist and post-existentialist philosophical process, having to do in the main with man's attempt to make sense of himself out of his senseless condition in the world, which makes no sense at all. The purpose of theater of the absurd is therefore to make a man face up to this haunting human condition as it is. Tradition prescribes that man must attempt to at least interpret and make sense of his environment. And someday, somehow, he will be full, of course, sense of their this paper of Buddhism is totally missing in Beckett's Godot. The predicament of the age in which the falsifying dreams of social structures that human beings have created to illusion themselves have all collapsed. Beckett is engaged in a savage attack on the European theater by using the technique of the theater of and its inventive power to expose this between ambience and realm, between sham and inner realm. Let us say the theatrical techniques are based on an acceptance of the metaphysic of the aspect. But this metaphysical aspect emerges through the minimalist use of stage properties and a total rejection of stage magic. While there is a tension between realism and the theatre of the absurd, it is not a trapping of the security of the theatricality of a well-made play, In the play, the very foundations of optimism raised by Western society are challenged. Beckett shows the mingled feelings of human feelings and relationships, as well as the sterility in the morality of life. The play can therefore be interpreted as a poetic image of emptiness and sterility, as well as a complex ritual of waiting. Beckett's presence, emotion, art, and stark picture of the world that has lost any kind of fabric. The play presents a host of individuals and insights who are deprived of normal living in Albacom campus, as he presents in the myth of Sisyphus. In the universe, and the sin of Jesus and life, man, fiend, an alien, an angel, his exile is without remedy, despite on the memory of a lost hope, or the hope of a promised land. His divorce between man and his life, the actor and his setting, is probably the feeling of absurdity. This feeling of absurdity marks Beckett's waiting for Godot, in which all the characters, all the adult characters, are presented as puny animals trapped in the hostile and alien world. This feeling of absurdity and self-imposed exile from the social world is generated, and there is a gross discrepancy between the real and the symbolic. While retaining the comic vein and dark humor of the other European absurdists, Beckett attempts to give a psychological verisimilitude to the characters. The result of this intermingling of realism, poetic drama, existentialism, and optimism of the absurd is of course unique. The play appears a realistic presentation of psychological frustration, as the entire action is presented as a ritual, a game, and process of unmasking. And the play provides a metaphysical perspective. The grim truth of importance and present symptom. One has been suffering from ailment in the legs, the other is suffering from frost. Grim truth of importance. See, pervades in the language of these ancient characters. The truth of mundane routine activities in the war ravaged and decadent society highlights the absurdity of this decadent, unstable, and sterile society. The dramaturgy of the absurd is used here to present the complexity of actions, action as well as motives, the repetition of words, phrases, and the games played by the characters. All these surround the fusion to survive the absurd. So in Waiting for Godot, the relation between truth and illusion is indeed a major theme. Some illusions are either shared privately or collectively, and then arise in the consciousness. The illusion of Godot is cherished to avoid the grim reality of the feelings. The play unfolds how the characters surrender themselves to such illusions without realizing that life must be lived without such illusions. By tackling the falsified dreams and reassuring lullabies created by Western society, the play focuses on the inadequacies in the language. In Beckett's for Godot, as in Beckett's practice, we find that characters are on a willing suspension and acceptance of suspension of this that Godot will not come. So, they depend on the willing acceptance of shared characters fail to transcend their situation, and their freedom can come only with the anguish of their choice. The irony of the title implies an important existential question. Why are they waiting for Godot? Why are they afraid to live without illusions? The distinction between truth and illusion is not readily perceived in the play. There is an uncertainty regarding a life without illusions. We must quote some lines from the play, then find a struggle. So, comes. Whoever comes and comes to the front holds his or her books and secret scissors. Installing crossbows. First of all, it says, let's go. Why not? We are waiting for Godot. Rami says, we are waiting for Godot. The son of the slave. Ah.
Thank you.
sinister rituals revolving around their act of hatred. Real! Crisis of religion and by the capitalist free world of human they create a sense of anguish. And this absurdity of history has are presented as existential and evil. Talk about aristocratic heroes, but in Beckett we have existential and evil. Who refuse to believe in either the glorious past or a promised land. By the horror of staring at reality is always tragic and absurd, localized in the conventions of social media, acceptance of ready-made ideas, self-delusions, and evasions of truth, and it is democratic. The fans of it, for Godot, are able to unite the independence of it. Godot is solid. What's hope? The fans are hope. But they are trying to see the magical inaction of it. Let us go. Be gone. Why not? We are waiting for Bolo. Scary. Voice of history. Ah. Of course. Characters seem to have resigned their life to unavoidable end of what if specifically delineated in the film. As it is pointed out that Beckett's characters wait for good. For pain, Godot is still the pain for the release from it. When killing the monotony of time, the event for people inventing a series of games, their verbal duels, their act of recognition, their narratives, their meaningless activities, all these touch upon the metaphysical dimension of the play is the fantasy of what is unmasking of all conventions in society to elaborate. Freedom in the play comes when the very fans are no longer afraid to conform and the truth of the future actors.
World.
That is almost outer world shaped every existence. So the Medusa also exposes them to this limited ground. So the on-ground existence in this open space for Godot does not get full support as Godot comes and invades this world. Although they refuse to participate in that race, their aspirations and expectations regarding Godot
and they don't position them. this world filtered by the expectations we carry. We do not understand them. So this is simply an anti-character that we find in the world. It's absurd drama. We have such characters whose motives are treated, whose actions we do not understand. So you can say that in today's play, we have no understanding of the motives of the characters. The inexplicable nature of Bozo's action and motivation is automatically in trouble. He's obsessed with time and go on. He is disgusted with that. While home depends, the sense of confidence and loss and the humility of his expectations create an atmosphere of cylinder, justice, and emotion. His encounter with the accident becomes explicit in acting. Here, he enters the stage, lying, guided by a dumb for Beckett, and it is the most tragic factor. And it's a habit, always a succession of habits. Sometimes habits are dangerous, tedious, painful, mysterious, even for time. Even for a moment, satisfying the boredom of living and subsequently the suffering of being, they all vanish. Waiting keeps on substantiating their being with characters of absurd drama participate in a series of absurd rituals, a series of habit plays that can be seen through their discussions, through their storytelling act, through the language games, through the slangs. They are all trapped in action or non-action. Without action cannot have a play. But here, there's tragic comedy to that, not as action. Action is inaction. Minus going on. That is a feeling of unreality, a search for an essential blend, forgotten, unnamed, that I am trying to express to my characters. To render endless, having nothing to call their own, apart from their worries, fears, lengthies, and the like. It's most appropriate in Beckett's work. A sense of purposelessness looms large as a transcript waiting for the actor to show. The conversation reveals a sense of emptiness. Thus, on the stage, Beckett realizes a sense of agitation, humility, worries, and emptiness. A language that combines the conversational dialogue with the faculty. In the book, The Language of Silence, this again has identified some defining elements used in the case of Beckett. What are these? His junctive, colloquial speech, pattern in realistic social setting, communicate disruption between participants in conversation and within the thought of a speaker. Here also we find hyperbole, understatement are all used for ironic interpretation of speaking words. There is an iron precision of language, as Inspiration points out, and the construction of writers only depends on the chaos of experience. It was first called the flow of other thoughts. So the silence and inspiration, silence plays a dominant role in the play. The words are placed between silence for written emphasis. There is an excessive use of language in the display, and there is a terrible inadequacy of English. A lot of words and words are used in this play. Verbal plays, and then there is personalities. The use of repetitions, words, expression, abrupt emphasis, this evaluation of language. One way, the danger of language. Through a heightened awareness of language, the characters can see intentions and emotion. For Beckett, language is used not to reveal, but to conceal, not to communicate, but just to repress. So meaning
becomes a problem in the future of language and communication terminates in the use of Rishi. Rishi becomes so action and gesture create the meaning of certain words. They say something and mean something different. Along with semantic confusion, simple items are distorted for confusion, comic effect, and for three forms of one of them is compressing up certain words that has lost its meaning. Because it loses anxiety, displays the loss, fear, disillusionment, and hypocrisy of post-war European society. It stands between the tragedy and farce, walking on the tightrope between tragedy and farce, and between naturalism and surrealism, between realism and realism. Blending the tragic and the comic, Beckett constantly fluctuates between the sorted existential crisis and the superficial entertainment. Situations in the play have whatever is difficult. There are some tension between the subject generally, and repressed pain generates a humor of horror. And in this case, the part of the this, we have humor of horror. All the comic vein, this goes underlying. We are just little parts, often in the absence. Such is the meaninglessness of it. In this way also the trans is several tricks and tricks. In endgame, ham whistles, and that is signifier of the game. Even if caps last 10, the recorded voices are played as in a game of memory. Here we find such games in and out. Performance of it. It keeps on using mimicry, parody, mime, farce, dance, some games are drawn from mundane domestic life, games of humiliation, blemish, socializing, adoration, appreciation. Some games are violent and aggressive, such as crucifixion, hanging, game of revenge, game of hostility, arrogance. Such games are the truth and conscious and the subconscious, the real and the dream. The trans play many games while they are looking for Godot and keep on searching for some Godot story. Combining the tricks of body mind and musical comedy, Beckett works on improvisational play. So high games are inventing games, language games, games of confusion, games of storytelling. The most important of these games is the game of narration or storytelling, as seen in Kozo's role as a ringmaster narrator. He is an orator for instance. We find several characteristic games played by Vladimir and Estrada, such as the game celebrating happiness, the game of happiness is played. But these are all episodes. Vladimir says, you must be happy to keep down. It's not a game. Have you what? To be back with you again? You say so? Say what? What am I to say? Say, I'm happy. So he says, I'm happy. So I am. And he says, we are happy. There's a silence. What do we do now? Now that we are happy? But he says, wait for Godot! These verbal games of Sikha Vithyas, monologues, and cross-talks are all used. And the skill of the monotony of space-time, keep on inventing some games, and the games are used as a device in the plot. The absurdity of the world is strongly emphasized. The whole being of Sisyphus is exerted towards accomplishing and attempts. The author pushing that huge stone up to the ground, which is the world, which is around the Saturday meeting with Godot, and this is what turned into our stop and a slow down, and then dance back to work. The night and night is the following challenge that happens. Thank you, and then the feedback, you can derive synthesis out of the chaos of the Kahun regarded Sisyphus happy. Refers to Oedipus' observation, a great quote from Sisyphus. Despite so many audience, my advanced age and the community of my soul make me conclude that all is true. Even though one always finds one, there is a renewal of hope that comes out that ambivalent feeling in waiting for Godot. Paradox in language and action. The best mark of it is cyclical. So in the end of each act of waiting for Godot, the trans athlete say, let us go! Close. The people say that the opening song of action summarizes what Beckett meant for this structure. Around the whole song, comes, dog came, begins in I, then swoops, pierces his throat, resumes, dog came in the stumble across the line, hit him till he was dead, then all dogs came running, dog, stops, moves, all the dogs came running and up from down the tomb, wrote about the tomb, I saw dog come. The dog came in the kitchen and stole across the fire, then hooked up with the dog, left him till he was dead, then all the dogs came running, up from the tomb, stops, moves, and all the dogs came running. And then the dogger, again he stops, moves, and then softens his head. And up the dogger. This verse, I don't know why, is a shark. It is beautiful and beautiful. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thank you, sir, for this presentation. I now invite questions and comments from the members of the audience. If you have any question, you may ask him, or you may send your questions in the chat box.
Yes, sir. Good morning. This is Varuna Ghosh. Sir, I have a question. Can you find the index between undecidability of the Sussurian linguistics, concept of absolute dhamma of Beckett, of the school of absolute theater. Because there is both there is undecided. There are undecided in the both contexts.
Half of this is meaningless statements that are there in this play. And yet they marks the failure of communication. Suppose we call two phenomena, talk about the failure of human communication. So words fail to create meaning. We are species. We are archaeology of knowledge based on words. We have seen Hamlet talking about words, words. He is wrapped in the net of words. It's like escape from that. And here again we find the tramps also are in this way of words. The tramps realize the activity of words. In this purpose. So when he said the word, when he becomes beautiful only when someone comes. When he ends, no one comes for whom the wind. What is the meaning of the word wind? So ready for Guru, you say this structural nonsense. Structural nonsense, you are waiting for Guru. Guru will never come. Because this wind will be partitioned. Then what is the meaning of wind? The wind has to be understood in terms of binaries. This is what Kasu is talking about. Conceive the world in terms of binaries. Understand the word rain. Non-arrival of Godo means the rain.
Yes, yes, thank you. You made it very clear. Thank you. Sir, okay.
Sir, there is a question in the chat box.
Now by the virus, we are wounded yesterday, we were wounded yesterday by the antagonistic forces that are always outside. So we are always haunted by the nightmare. So remember that person, Stanley Weber, who has taken a seaside refuge in a resort in the house of Megan Pitty in Harold Pinter's the birthday party. So he wants to escape from something. We are also trying to escape from something. Past haunts us, the present we are unsure of, and yet we are waiting. Waiting for what? Are we waiting for something? We were waiting yesterday for lockdown to be lifted. We were waiting yesterday for the vaccine to be lifted. We are waiting now for the vaccine. For the time when the lockdown and yet we are unsure whether the normalcy, once it returns, will make us anyway meaningful, make our existence anyway meaningful. So we are waiting, waiting, waiting. So to quote Mirza Ghalib, Mirza Ghalib has said, he has quite Mirza Ghalib. So letdowns are always there. Once the letdown is there, we again keep on waiting. This really defines this modern condition, especially in an age of rat race, where we are chasing our dreams that are simply like mirage. All this is visible, but once we reach that oasis, all this is no longer in sight. So Godot is like that oasis, mirage, and hallucination.
something. So believe in life.
And unreal.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for being a part of the program. We are there. We are in real time, real situation. We are there. And we are actually doing it.
Messengers for confusion. Messengers
just tell stories but they also realize stories. And therefore the communication is done on the basis of the voice, your identity in appearance but non-identical, purpose and their directory. Because this is but both come to the same synthesis that overcome. In the stage productions that Beckett did not support, we have use of identical the same boy actor, on the role of the boy actor and the boy actor. In the productions that were approved by Beckett, he suggested that there should be some difference for one over the other. So I must say that going by Beckett, I can say that yes, this is a different person.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.